下个五年，我们要向1100公斤、1200公斤挑战攻关，我们还要实现超级稻，还可以在稻穗下乘凉，圆我的禾下乘凉风。
此时此刻，空气当中都弥漫着沉重的味道。可能对于很多人来说，这一刻可以用泪目来形容，因为在今天下午的1点07分。Because
at 1:07 this afternoon, Beijing time,
送别了我们国家的一位国士大家，他的名字。We
send farewell to a great person. And his name was Yuan Longping. He's a winner of the national title, honorary title, and also known as the father of a hybrid rice. And every time we enjoy a bowl of rice, so the certain piece of rice may relate it to Mr. Yuan. So when we heard the news, I saw many people just really think about the role played by Mr. Yuan Longping and the value he created. Just through a small seed, he changed the whole world. That small seed of rice also demonstrated and witnessed the difficulties and challenges he overcame. From that seed to the vast land of paddy field, he grew up and planted his merit. He had dreams, and every time when we saw him, that he always shared his dream that he could actually enjoy the cool underneath the rice crops. Actually, he had that dream. And he said that is the rice really long and like the each piece, like the core or the a peanut, larger size than corn. And that actually he could sleep and enjoy that moment of cool underneath the rice crops. This is a so beautiful dream that he devoted his whole life to make that dream come true. Unfortunately, he passed away before that dream came true. To the news reporters, actually, we always that pay attention to the news that he admitted to the hospital and received treatment. We hope that miracle happened because, like, Mr. Yuan created several miracles in his life in the rice field in China. But unfortunately, he not created his life miracle today, but he could create another one in another world, in the heaven.
Many friends have already seen his
I saw a lot of people, I reposted Mr. Yuan's memory with the friends, and he played violin, he played volleyball, he chatted with his friend, a lot of really cute moments. A lot of people also shared, reposted that video clip, that memory of Mr. Yuan. As long as we remember all these moments, Mr. Yuan was along with us, just next to us. So with this special coverage, we hope our friends are also with us to express our appreciation to Mr. Yuan Longping. Our correspondent today will also share their memory when they had an interview with Mr. Yuan or interviewed the person in the hospital, what they have seen, what they had experienced. Hope through our stories, that the a short moment with Mr. Yuan, we hoped could bring that vivid picture to our viewers. His loves, his personalities, his straightforward style, and also that he always said that the Chinese people should hold our rice bowl firmly in our both hands, and in that rice bowl should be rice planted and grown here in China. So in today's live streaming, let's recall all these memories. So for myself, I interviewed Mr. Yuan Longping 3 times in the past 1 decade. So for myself today, actually also a hard time for myself, because at this moment, I need to make this live streaming, I need to control my motion, but actually a lot of pictures, just like playing back that film, I couldn't control myself, but all these pictures just right now in front of my face. Like he said, like, you don't know these, that, you know, like back then, like we really have that a tendency toward bolting and exaggeration. So that when you waited, the yield, I could not be there, because like I could not be an athlete, also the judge at the same time. He also said to me that I didn't feel quite well in my physical strength, that before I didn't even have a fever, but right now I had a fever. That could be something wrong with the immune system. That's also from Mr. Yuan Longping in our interview. I also would like to thank all the colleagues because they found the video clip. So let me share with you this video clip. Let's look one more time. Let's back to the time and also to back to the memory with Mr. Yuan. And the first, let's saw the a clip when Mr. Yuan was in his 84. That video clip, that interview lasted 20 minutes. That's the after auditing. That's the edited film. But actually, there are a lot of details and also behind the scenes I would like to share with you after we saw that video clip. So let's first see what Mr. Yuan in his 84, what he said to us. So the Wednesday, that's the World Food Day. A lot of people not familiar with that day because a lot of people really still suffer in hunger. But to that person, most of his big milestones related to food. Where we say that his life so related to rice. Rice is a staple food so important to Chinese people. And Mr. Yuan was in his 84, and also Yuan Longping also got his Live Run Award. And also a big news for him is not only that lifetime achievement award, actually he got his new world record. That's the record of the output. So that's a new world record. So same as your expectation, yes, I'm so satisfied. But right now look at that 1,000 kilograms, not reached yet. Yes, you could not really build Rome overnight. Right now we reach 988.1 kilogram. That's still a big milestone, just 11.9 kilograms in short, but actually you saw that a small number actually should make a ground change. If we make that breakthrough, we have that confidence that before 2015 we could reach the threshold. So you spent 2 years to reach that goal. 2 years is not long, I can tell you. It's not an easy job. So this year we only had one experimental field, and the next year we hope we could have 3 fields. So we have more opportunity. So under the current weather condition, that we had that yield of 988.1, I'm so satisfied. And we should intensify our efforts. I hope that we could reach that goal of 1,000 kilogram.
2005年实现亩产800公斤, 到2011年,
so the yield rate
在这块试验田上,
from the 700 to 800 to 900 kilograms, Mr. Yuan Longping, so the broke the world record made by himself, and he had the every reason to believe. For the yield rate, and also you could see that he didn't present on the field, he just made the admission in his office. So he made the calculation in his office. So why were you not there presented at the field? So you could think about this. We actually are the A players, and they are the judges. It's better we not present it there, so they not really worry too much. So actually, it's better let them do the job by themselves. I believe it's not good for myself to be there. I don't want to impact the final result. So based on the fact, they do the calculation. The Ministry of Agriculture gave the final result 988.1 kilogram. But according to the world record, that could be more than 1,000 kilograms. But for the Mr. Yuan, that he didn't want to have an easy result. They talk about that back then, a lot of people really see something exaggerated. So in 1958, people went so exaggerated, and we don't want to have that tendency toward boasting and exaggeration. So for us, we were the one who knew exactly how hard we are. So feared of hunger for sure. We talk about that, the 100 kilogram, and you added additional challenges, just want to plant it more. I don't want to say something big, this is for the food security, this is the greater good, yes, that play a role, but for myself, I had that internal energy. I couldn't tell you why. I believe that just like when I was born, that already something inherent inside my body. or maybe that the a peculiar wild rice species found by Mr. Yuan Longping, and also that's the a breakthrough made by Mr. Yuan. So that discovery by him also later on rolled out in our larger areas. So the hybrid rice replanted the 57% of the a total paddy fields. And also he is the most significant figure in China. When we mention about hybrid rice, a super hybrid rice, actually your name has been mentioned. Actually too much, don't mention too much. So I received 18 international award. So this time for the a super hybrid rice for yourself was the percentage of your contribution. I just lied some products. But it's not just a single person's award or the contribution. And we had the phase two, phase three, phase four. This is our roadmap. So I, for myself, I believe I received too much awards. So that should be fair. So I don't want to too much under the spotlight. So I would talk about that we should let more people enjoy that award. I don't want my face or my name on that list. So I played a leading role for the research. So the people saying that because you're displayed as a flag, so that could be guaranteed that the a more the a funding channel to your products, and also your products easier to be awarded. Maybe my name could have played a little bit role. So you're worried about that, the sustainability. We could not every time that put your name at the top. So for myself is that the a mega projects I could sign up, but for the a normal projects I don't want to sign or have my name on it. I just want to be and humble and down to the earth. So people saying that because Mr. Yuan enjoyed a lot of the a powers, that he is the member of the CPPCC 5 years ago, and he also got the a special driving lessons. Although he passed a old age, Mr. Yuan Longping, in 1984, he organized this research center, and he totally in charge of that R&D projects, human resources, and he actually is called a big father. And you had the a pool of talent. Easier to manage the team? So you talk about that scholars or talents tend to scorn each other. So it's more like a technical person, but right now also in charge of management. So for the a human resources type of thing, it's not my type of thing. So it's like a plant rice, actually, it's very simple, easy. So for myself, it's like I'm a quite simple person. And also it's really hard to manage money, right? Unfortunately, I'm really failed in managing everything. But in 1996, he established a company. And for Mr. Yuan's personality, actually need to strike a balance with that listed company. That the your partner in the company is saying that you the a system in the company is that you would like to share the benefits with everyone. But right now, it's like you need to know that you should have that priority. Otherwise, people don't have that incentive. So in your team, people do more, they can get more. Yes. Especially right now, we have a new species that they also can get additional incentives. So you will get the most every time. And we also had a policy. I get a proportion of it, not the most. A lot of fund, because I also established a foundation. I also put that foundation to the money to that foundation. So for the company, Mr. Yuan Longping owned 5% of the share, and he actually have a high standards to the scientists. So we don't want to you as a millionaire or the a high ranking officials. It's impossible if you devoted yourself in the agriculture sector. But actually you have that listed company. So you talk about my share, I also could not sell, right? I cannot sell my share, otherwise the a share price of my company dropped. So the a millionaire for me, just like the I'm the mental millionaire to other people. So talk about my value, they always talk about that I worth of 100.8 billion. So people think I enjoy that fame, enjoying that that's the wealth. It seems like you have everything. So talk about fame and wealth, actually I not really look into it. I didn't pursue it. So become a brand, actually yourself. But actually you think I'm a brand, but for myself, I'm just saying it's a burden. So it's actually limits my movement, not feel freedom. So it's like your teacher always give you that comment, it's like you enjoy that freedom. I still enjoy that freedom. I not really follow the rules. So you could see that actually people punch or clock in, but for myself, I couldn't follow that. And there is a volleyball field, and also Mr. Yuan refused to join the team with the other silvers because he always considered himself born after 1990s. He also played like swimming and play violin. So people not really mention about the age in front of Mr. Yuan. So still like a folk song, old black Joe. That's a very classic folk music. But it's a sad song. So in 2004, I backed to my hometown, Duan. It's a huge change happened there in Duan. But I also actually not really wanted to go back because like just when I came back, a lot of people really land at the both sides of the road waiting for me. So it's impossible. You just like came there like secretly. It's impossible. So maybe bring the a hats, the sunglasses, masks. I hope that I can cover myself. So during our interviews, actually could he also hear that he's suffering some hearing losses, and he said that he was told by a doctor with a TCM that he could live to 98 years old. So you could see that before I didn't have any fever, but right now I had a fever. I believe that I could have something wrong in my immune system. So talk about actually, it's like I'm in my 80s, my physical it feels like 50s, but my mindset is 30s. So at the end of our interview, he said he's a little bit negative, but actually he still changed a homemade car and also participate in other activities. And also in September of 2014, he also aimed to hit a new target, a new world record, although he was in his 80s. But we talk about whether we can have the talent that can carry forward his job. That's an interview 8 years ago in 2013. And because his super hybrid rice had broken a new world record of 900 kilograms. So we had that interview with Mr. Yuan. I also had a regret that my makeup was a little bit over, so that is why I had that my studio makeup, because the original setting was planned in a studio. But when we arrived there, we found that a whole situation, that the room in the hotel actually not really good for the lighting. So we also talk about with Mr. Yuan to negotiate with them that is it possible that we could find something outdoor, that because that may have some traffic or the cars or people's going by. Do you mind? And Mr. Yuan, without a second of hesitation, he just said, let's go. So it's a noisy place. You could see that the passengers or cars going by, but the impression of Mr. Yuan to me is like he's so optimistic. He always uses smile to solve the difficulties. So the people actually working for Mr. Yuan actually said that you should be always alert, that you should always keep all the numbers in your mind, and also you need to go to the field. If you fail to go into the field, then you could not be my student. So for the Israel love freedom, a lot of things outside work, it's just at will. He's not really care about when's the time to take food. Actually, his wife and his kids actually spend actual efforts. And also in the end of the interview, he also said about his immune system. He is a bit negative because he actually had fever. But you could see that just 2 or 3 days after that interview, he participated in the event to promoting the rice event. A lot of people said farewell to Mr. Yuan. A lot of people had expressed our appreciation, our respect to Mr. Yuan. And one of our correspondents in Hunan, and the correspondent also accompanied the last moment of Mr. Yuan. Let's see what stories he would like to share with us about Mr. Yuan Longping. So right now we are in the Xiangya Hospital. So we are right now in the hospital. This is the Xiangya Hospital of Hunan Province. It's 1:07 p.m. The respected Mr. Yuan Longping passed away at the age of 91. And also with family's will, that the vehicle carrying Mr. Yuan will also go to the rice field. So that was the place where Mr. Yuan devoted his whole life. And that will be the hybrid rice research center. So let's also made our way toward that place. So look at the A right building. That was the place he spent his last moment, and he died of multi-organ failure. And right now you're looking at this vehicle that should be the one. We're not really sure, but let's first follow that vehicle. But according to our knowledge,
还有这个一点时间，那么我们呢？ 先行抵达这个杂交的研究中心.
That the A vehicle will head to the A hybrid rice research center. So I will also cross check. But actually, that maybe is not that one, but we also make our way to that DA research center. I could share with you that the last moment of Ms. Yuan, I was also there, that he just like he was sleeping. He's in a very serene state with a little bit smile. And also started from yesterday evening, his students, his family members. Accompanied with him. And also they sang together. The songs loved by Mr. Yuan.
Thank you.
And also his granddaughter shared with me the story that Mr. Yuan loved one son. It's like, I love you so much, just like the mouse like the rice. So that's the line from that song. It's a pop song. And also that the family members and the people gathered together singing that song. And I also saw that Mr. Yuan actually made see a slightly response by nodding his hand and also smiling slightly. And his student, Dr. Xin Yeyun, said that fight on, Mr. Yuan. You are right now enjoying the cool underneath the tall and big strong rice crops. Look at the ear of rice. It's really tall, and each and every rice seed is as big as a peanut. It's a really touching moment. In the past 11 years, we witnessed the whole journey of Mr. Yuan's second edition and third edition of super hybrid rice. The yield rate from 800 kilogram to 900 kilogram to 1,000 kilogram. Actually, we were all there. And every time you talk about that, a big test, we talk about that last year, the super hybrid rice, and the experts from the Ministry of Science and Technology and also from Ministry of Agriculture all were there to check the final result of the yield rate to see that output. And before the big day, and the paddy field actually was heavily impacted by the strong rain. But on that big day, in that morning, he was there. But actually started from last year, he was in the wheelchair. But he was in a good spirit and saw that the keys playing volleyball, and he was really happy. So I asked him, Mr. Yuan, it's your big day today. Not nervous? He said, why nervous? I'm not nervous. He said that you should be even calm on that big moment. So he laughed and said, no problem. So we also had the news coverage. So we accompanied with Mr. Yuan to witness that moment. So when the results of 1,500 kilogram announced at Mr. Yuan in his 90s, actually just smelled like a big kid. So you could still have that picture with Mr. Yuan laughed so loud. And at that moment, he was in the wheelchair.
Okay.
现在离咱的中心走了四分之一，有没有？啊，差不多了。把这个门关一下，有点吵。到现在都不敢相信，这么一个老顽童似的，一位可敬、可爱、可亲的一位尊长，跟着走。
For myself, I still could really buy in this sad news. And Mr. Yuan passed away. And also, actually, for Mr. Yuan, he had really a simple lifestyle. And also, his student reported to him about the updated progress made and the third generation of a super hybrid rice. That the a team also set a higher goal for this year. And they also think about how to better the change or improve the soil. And for the land with saline alkaline, and whether they can change the seed, so to change the whole soil. So they also achieved some progress in this regard. Thank you, our correspondent. He shared with us his personal experience. So from his story, and also help us to know more about Mr. Yuan Longping. Also, we heard about his family members, his colleagues, his students, his son. Together. So right now our correspondent on the way to Mr. Yuan's office, the Hybrid Rice Research Center. So we will also later on have him back. And we talk about that we should cherish each and every piece of the rice in our rice bowl. So we talk about that every grain always prove that hard work made by the heroes behind that just a small seed of rice. So that is why we mentioned many times that we should save food. And also we would like to invite more people to share with us about their memories with Mr. Yuan, because we know Mr. Yuan actually was a really cute person. He really liked to laugh. So we invite a colleague that when he had an interview in the paddy field when Mr. Yuan was 76 years old. Our special guest, Mr. Xia, so 15 years ago, when Mr. Yuan was 76 years old, you were the A2 young man, right? So what did you talk about in that pad field in your interview? So that time, actually, he paid a visit to Anhui Wuhu to check one of the experimental field of the hybrid rice. So we actually waited him, and when he arrived, he directly went to the paddy field. I actually could tell you he walks so fast. Actually, he walked, but we ran. And he wore that straw hat, and he also checked one after another the ear of rice. So I also asked him that actually Mr. Yuan could feel that you were happy. And he said to me that you, the reporters, to broadcast a news related to agriculture field. So you could know that actually I'm so happy because when I see these speck of rice, just like I see my kids. They are all my kids. So we were there with him. So I asked him about his plan to roll out the hybrid rice in Anhui, and he also gave me a number about his rolling out plan. And the vice governor of Anhui also was there and also talked with Ms. Yuan Longping. So the governor said that they will fully give full support to that rollout plan. And Mr. Yuan also laughed very loud. Actually, I still could remember that his big smile. I believe that his attitude toward science really worth to learn for all of us. That scientific spirit. So we talk about his dream, that enjoying the cool underneath the rice crops. I believe that should be the goal for the generations of rice scientists. And also Mr. Yuan asked the farmers in the padded fields that we also help you to increase the earnings. What else did you want? Actually, he also had quite a good conversation with the local farmers. So he had that the straw hat at his hand as a fan because it's a really hot day. So also he sweated a lot. And he also asked the farmers what the additional requirements they had. I believe that also his special feelings and also that bond to the country, to the party, to the people. We talk about the scientists, they are the precious assets
这个呢，我觉得袁老师他把自己的人生理想与国家民族的奋斗目标结合起来，这也是我们。
So I talk about actually Mr. Yuan also devoted himself to make the benefits to the whole country. Thank you for your sharing. I believe from your lines, we could really have that picture vividly and ask the local farmers about that their needs, their additional requirements, what kind of things that he could do to the farmers.Thank you so much. So I also saw that a lot of people saying that. So when I had an interview with Mr. Yuan in his 87th, I asked him whether he still paid a visit to the paddy field. He said yes. Actually, for myself, my first question come to my mind is like, how? Because we talk about the paddy field, actually a lot of them actually in a remote place and a quite a difficult situation. And he told us that before he actually said that I didn't wear that the raining boots. And so he said that before just wear that the a.Vulcanized shoes was enough, but right now, and he that back to his 87, he said that he actually needed to change to the big raining boots. So how actually he evaluated himself to be a qualified agronomist, that the only ruler or the environment himself to.Check the paddy field is to that himself by his own eyes to check the quality of the rice. And the only standard he evaluated himself is to see whether he still can go to the paddy field. In his whole life of the research.That it's not just we saw that the keep increasing the output of that paddy field, actually the assets he left to us. That because like Mr. Yuan, these group of people actually, they protect us so well.Like Mr. Yuan of this world, they are the one that creates the good life for all of us. So that's the everlasting assets that Mr. Yuan left to us.And also Mr. Yuan still with us, but just changed to another form because right now he's the a shining star. And you could also see that right now in our pictures that Mr. Yuan also played Tai Chi. And before actually that the, you could really tell actually he was a really good player because he also actually got the A medal in the swimming competition. Although people really thought he was so slim, not really muscular, actually he's really good in the A volleyball and also swimming. And also in his life in the 87th, he asked me that every day he played that the volleyball. So just he changed his role, not as the a speaker to the a second transmitter. So he just changed the role, but you look at Mr. Yuan was still on the court. who play volleyball. He said it's not important to win or lose the game, and that because of me, everyone really like have that passionate to sports. I believe that we should feel more energy or alive. So that sort of energy is that you need, because that you have more passion to be devoted to something you like, to your career. So that's something that his mom told him. So you could see that this is a footage that Mr. Yuan playing volleyball. So he could not really jump high, maybe that we could see that it's really good scene that So always could see the big smiles. So we could see that Ms. Yuan played volleyball with hands and also foot. And also he said that he rejects that hear the word old, because like he said, there is no that character in his dictionary. So that is why he also rejected to join a silver team. So as a journalist, we always had that regret that whether we could make our interviews even longer, so we could spend longer time with Mr. Yuan, because there should be more to be discovered about Mr. Yuan. So you could see that he also breathes a little bit heavily. That also was his old trouble.
这个袁老打排球的资料我真的是第一次看这么久，可以看到。
So I believe this could be the very first time for all the viewers to see this live footage.
还要继续打，这已经很长时间了。
Mr. Yuan playing volleyball.
我们看着可能不觉得时间就这样划过，但其实对于袁老当时的年龄来说，
for Mr. Yuan in his age,actually, like playing, walking, running, jumping, receiving the balls, it's not an easy job for his age. And also, that's the amateur career back to 2008 for Peking Olympic Games.
哎，这是老顽童的样子啊！袁老穿着西装，这是哎呀，这是在跳什么舞
？Dancing, right?
我是一个不会跳舞的人哈，所以没有办法。
Could not really know what kind of.
哦，我们导播示意我说是踢踏舞。
The dance.
哇
，That's the tap dance.
在更年轻的时候，因为他弹跳力明显很好。这袁老，其实他说话跟。他打排球特像，就是弹跳力特别好。他说话很多时候像弹簧一样。有同事问过我说：“您怎么用弹簧来形容他讲话？”他思维的跳跃性
很强。So actually, Mr. Yuan is really a good jumper, and also in the interview, he also actually he thought really jumping a lot.And you could really give you all the answers to your questions with a reasonable ground.
I
believe it's a group of people, Mr. Yuan, that cared so much.
Mr.
Yuan's beloved people, that these group of people planted and harvest and hybrid rice.
来看看他现在最想跟我们说什么。您好，您知道了。这个消息的时候，
是一个什么样的状态啊？
我们中午收到消息的时候，
我们收到such news at noon。
真正被通过分了。
We were really sad。Because we loved him so much， we fully respected him。
我们检查厅的墙，这个天气空气检查查停了，好凉啊。
您曾经跟袁老在相处的时候
，So you worked with Mr. Yuan. So what's the most deepest memory? What is the deepest memory in your mind? So this is September 12th. We received around 200 experts from Ministry of Science and Technology and Ministry of Agriculture. Actually, that was my first time to meet Mr. Yuan in 2009.Actually, he was already in his 80s, but I couldn't really tell.
And
why did you say this? So when he visited the experimental field, And actually, I tried to support him with my hand because that the experimental field actually was not easy to walk. He said that don't worry,
他感到非常的高兴呢，而他的脚伸到尾巴里边，
He's not good enough to walk.
这种拉的活，他根本就不怕。
He also said to me that this is actually is considered this is not a difficult for him. And also in his 80s, but you could tell that he still considered him as a young man. And not giving to his age.So, also he so devoted himself to improve the output. So, what did he say to you? So, he actually visits 9 times to our experimental field.Starting from 2009, and he visited twice in 2015. Every time when he visited, actually, all the farmers actually gathered there. He really liked to eat peanut, so the peanut and egg, a sweet potato.Pumpkin, actually, he really loved the food grown from our land. I remember that in 2012, In order to increase the yield of the super hybrid rice, we need to have a high yield and a supreme quality of seeds. Plus, the technique for planting. So in 2015,The most impressive thing, to me is that he introduced and told us about how to plant a hybrid rice. He talked about that a good quality of seed should be the core and a good technology should be the guarantee to have the, a high yield rate. So we also need to have a good the environment, should have good sunshine, raining, the fertilizer. So actually you could really tell a lot of these memories, these details.So we talk about we should have the, a really good environmental conservation. We also need to have that the attitude and a good mindset.So the, just now the farmer from Hunan actually shared with us about the night visit to his experimental field and also shared about some tips for plantation.
我们得跟随我们的总台央视记者谢宝军回到
And also let's get back to Mr. Yuan's office.
我们来看看这个他一直战斗到付出到他生命最后一刻的他最看重的那个地方都有什么都留下了什么
央视新闻的网友，大家好，我是总台记者谢。
So right now our correspondent arrived at the
第一场直播是从中央大学湘雅医院，那么现在
Mr. Yuan's office So we made our way from the hospital to the Hunan Hybrid Rice Research Center. According to our latest information, the vehicle with Mr. Yuan's body departed from the hospital, and the whole route is planned that from this way. So the vehicle arrived at the exhibition hall, and then to this experimental building, and then the vehicle proceeded to the center, that's the office building. And also look at the characters, actually also written by Yuan Longping himself, is to develop a hybrid right to benefit people of the world and then to his home. So basically this is the planned route. So we also see that right now we have some people gathering here. A lot of the people, residents, media, students gathered here to say farewell to Mr. Yuan Longping. So this is the Mr. Yuan's office building, and is in this building in the office, Mr. Yuan and his team made several breakthroughs here. So we actually witnessed a world record of Mr. Yuan's hybrid rice. Mr. Yuan was so devoted. He spent his whole life in the research of a hybrid rice. And Mr. Yuan actually pulled countless people out of hunger. So the story of Mr. Yuan, a team tried to hit the goal of 1,000 kilograms. I was here with Mr. Yuan, waiting for the results.
我在这里采访袁老师，我们预定的是当时是两点钟要进行这个。
And Mr. Yuan's home just next to this building.
看能不能穿一下哈，来，亚芳跟着我穿一下，是有一段距离。当时我一点钟的时候，两点钟直播。
So our interview was scheduled at 2 p.m. So at 1 p.m., actually, Mr. Yuan loved a lot of things, a lot of habits. He played the volleyball, violin. Actually, look at in this center, everyone actually know how to play volleyball. And also Mr. Yuan play chat, play goals, and also like to play mahjong. So when we were arrived,
that
Mr. Yuan just playing mahjong with the family members. So at around 1:40 p.m., Mr. Yuan said, let's go. Let's prepare for the interview. So this is the office building. So from his home to the office. It's around 5 minutes walk. So around 1:50 p.m. we arrived at 2 o'clock. We had the live interview with the studio. Actually, there's no that the a briefing before that.
每一粒 穗子 有多少粒 然后 这个一兜 有多少株 一亩
So for Mr. Yuan, actually, he remembered all the numbers so accurately in his mind about the yield rate, about the number of the specks of rice.
说小谢怎么样没给你掉链子的吧然后说完哈哈大笑
And also after that interview, he actually said to me that, say, I didn't make any trouble to you, right? And actually, you could see, actually, he's so innocent and so lovely.
Yuan老 去从海南做完这个海水道之后
And also we have a correspondent actually we met some foreign friends in Hainan, actually from Africa. So the academician Yuan actually just finished his visit to the experimental field in Hainan, and on his way back to Hunan, actually met the African friends really so excited and call academician Yuan, my father. And African people also take photos with Commission Yuan. We talk about the Mr. Yuan Longping not only solve the food security issue in China, talk about that we need to have good seed, good technology, and good environment to grow hybrid rice. Right now, in the more than 10 countries, including Africa, United States, so right now, all planting hybrid rice. And right now, also in Madagascar, 5 days ago, the super hybrid rice reached a record of
800 kilograms.
And also we should mention that at the face of their currency, they also have the one speck of hybrid rice in order to show the respects to Mr. Yuan. Very soon we will see the vehicle with Mr. Yuan Longping's body coming back home.
打一下来，把司机打一下。
哎，喂，到哪儿了？到哪儿了？过省委啊、哦，好好好，那估计还有二十分钟，我已经到这中心了。好，行，20分钟啊，好。哎，要不？哎，
鱼还有刀。
好。可以吗？啊？现在长沙的雨越来越大。现在袁老师他们的车已经离杂交的中心大概还有一刻钟到二十分钟的车程。
15 to 20 minutes。
我们看到刚才的镜头，就是很多树林啊，紫花的。
And also could see that a local resident.
现在花了，求实创新。
Also sent the flowers here.
记得在跟袁老在聊天的时候，他也专门寄语青年人怎样才能成功。
And also in our interview, also asked the how that the a young generation could be successful. So he also said about that knowledge, sweat, that the a inspiration and opportunity.So that's the four key words Mr. Yuan gave to the young generation.
而且袁隆平院是他的超级灶，过去主要是解决这个吃饭温饱问题。
We talk about hybrid or the super hybrid, right? He, for the first generation, more dealing with the food security issues, but right now coming to the third generation of super hybrid rice, right now the goal already shaped to how we can have a better tasted rice. 2010年年初
我们做的
第一条访问袁隆平院士的电视叫《种下金种
子，种下金种子，农民好收
成》。We had a title
called
Planting Golden Seed would benefit the farmers. So this is the golden seed we talk about.
袁老师用他毕生的精力解决了多少人
So Ms. Yuan's his whole life
我刚才也翻了一下我的
to bring that benefit to the people not only in China but also around the world
这是2010年那时候
So this is the picture in 2010 when Ms. Yuan turned to 80 years old So talk about planting gold seed so the farmers can have a good harvest. And that is also the very long and heavy specks of rice. So that's around 5 to 10 minutes. Very soon we will see the vehicle carrying Mr. Yuan's body coming back home. And also we could see that right now we have a lot of local residents gathering here to say farewell to Mr. Yuan. So that is the gate very soon. We will see the vehicle. And also we could see the firecrackers also prepared as a also local tradition. I believe we also could see that a lot of people gathering here are the students from the Agricultural University of Hunan.
现在就在附近的湖南农大的学生越聚越多，我刚进来的时候大概也就几十人，现在已经几百人了，已经。
I could see that more than 200 people gathering here.
送别一下袁老师。
I'd like to say goodbye to Mr. Yuan.
这些孩子们。
The students from the Agricultural University.
最大的网红，这些孩子们都是学农的，然后很多也是特别希望能够接着袁老师的接力棒。
And they always considered Mr. Yuan as a role model, and they also would like to carry forward the noble course of Mr. Yuan. to develop a third and fourth generation of a super hybrid rice. So you could see people lying at both sides of the road.
紧紧地握着他的手，然后袁老的侄孙女又按的给老太太按的按头，跟他梳的梳头，然后按的按肩。
And also Mr.
Yuan's
wife accompanied him yesterday evening.Holding Mr. Yuan's hand, and also the family members were also there. And also could see that a banner is also unfolded.
Yuan 老爷子真的走了。今天我的手机短信里收了很多我的同事、我的朋友，他们都说真相，这是一条。
So everyone in deep mourning
已经成了事实了
for this great man.
Yuan 老走的那个表情，一辈子都会定格在我的脑海中，真的就像一个。沉睡中的一位睡午觉的一位老人，嘴角上扬，而且表情非常非常的安详，非常慈祥的一位老人。现在雨又越下越大了，
Mr. Yuan right now coming back home. And also follow the local tradition, the firecrackers ignited. So the planned route is from this gate, first at the exhibition hall, and then to the Seed Research Center building, and then to his office building, and then we're heading to Mr. Yuan's home. So we could see that the vehicle moved slowly. And this is also Mr. Yuan's last wish. And he hoped to went back to his office one more time. He spent his life here. Right now, the fleet also stopped at the office building, and then right now proceeding to the national laboratory. And then the vehicle will approach to Mr. Yuan's home. So we will take a shortcut directly to Mr. Yuan's home. So that's the planned route. And this is Mr. Yuan's home. This is his house.
让一下，让一下，
不要挡到门口，不要挡到门口。
原来是哪去的路好不好，让原来是走好好不好。
右边上去，右边上去啊。
从来没有看到过这样的场面，这么多的群众都自发的来，发自内心对元老的崇敬。
So people are here voluntarily say goodbye to Mr. Yuan.Everyone in really deep mourning for this great person. I believe this is an unforgettable moment for everyone.
摄像姚鹏他们走散了，这里有学生，就连黄文公也来到这里来。
So we not only see students here, we also see the sanitation workers also here to say farewell to Mr. Yuan Longping. So Mr. Yuan came back home and also went around his office, and I could tell you that there are around more than 1,000 people gathering here. I see students, I also see sanitation workers, and people with different dialects from different places, all coming here to say goodbye to Mr. Yuan. So in our interview, and he said that Israel loved the poem written by Chairman Mao about the Long March. So I believe that the generations of the people working for hybrid rights will carry forward his spirit and his work, and the Chinese people will for sure hold our rice bowl firmly in our hand. Just now, we accompanied Mr. Yuan, went back to his home. And it was also his last wish. People cried a lot, and also people that see the live streaming or even see that Mr. Yuan either on your mobile phone or in the different interviews. And we saw the video clip that Mr. Yuan playing volleyball or playing step dance. I believe that no one or not a lot of people really saw that Mr. Yuan's home and also the way from his home to his office. So for us, that Mr. Yuan's final wish was completed. He went back home. That's the energy source for himself, that's the energy for his life, and we talk about the home, that's the small home for himself, and also talk about the home, about the research center. So we talk about going back home, it's not only mentioned about his own house, but also talk about his bigger home, that's his office, his research center. So we could see people still gathering here, and also people that always say that Ms. Yuan, thank you so much. Thank you for your contribution. We will not forget you. The Chinese philosophy also represents sadness, that we're not willing him to leave. So for this live streaming, I'd, I also would like that the colleagues and the friends to share with the memory. And also I told the news to my mom, and my mom is in her 71 years old. My mom also cried aloud. Because for my mom's generation, they know hunger so well because they experienced that famine. So they know exactly how rice is so important to us. So talk about that in the interview that Mr. Yuan also mentioned about hunger, about that the lag actually were swallowed. That is why these group of people devoted their life to let people have enough food. So people, and for her generation, for my mom's generation, and for Mr. Yuan, they know exactly the taste of hunger. They know that feeling of hunger, and the fear of hunger. So that is why they don't want the same feeling coming back again. And we should thank Mr. Yuan that we will not taste the hunger. And he also said that it is impossible that Chinese people will experience that feeling of hunger again. And the vehicle right now is heading to the funeral parlors. We hope that the clock had slow or even stopped so we can spend a longer period with Mr. Yuan, and also let Mr. Yuan have time to see Changsha, the place he was living, and also maybe possible to his hometown. We saw people lying up there alongside to say farewell to Mr. Yuan. I also admire this group of people because they stand closer to Mr. Yuan. And Mr. Yuan actually really loved people gathering together because he loved that to love with people together, to sing together, to dance together, play volleyball together, or play go together, play Chinese chess, playing swimming. Like, you could see that this is actually all the group activities. So we know what he loved. So we also were here to accompany him. And also say to him that we know he will always there. The vehicle right now is on the way to the funeral parlor.
能够看到他非常善意的，当他的镜头停留在一些人哭泣的脸上的时候，他善意的离开，转过去，他看到了每个人的悲伤。
And also through our cameraman,
其实他也不希望这样的悲伤
that we know everyone is in deep mourning.And also our cameraman actually not really have that, the cameras staring at these people. And we don't want to say farewell in tears, in sadness, because we know Mr. Yuan's personality. He was a really like lovely person. He liked everyone laughing because he always had a big smile on his face.So maybe it's not the tears, let's use our smile to say big goodbye. I believe that may be the way Mr. Yuan likes.
画面，其实这段时间我们也是在静静的等，等待更多的网友可以把你们心里在想到元老的时候想到什么都告诉我们。我们很多的人啊，在说到
I believe people have different memories related to Mr. Yuan Longping.
一生所追寻的那个禾下乘凉梦
That one of the a thing we always mentioned is about his dream that he could actually enjoy the cool underneath the rice crops. And he said that once is enough, just one time.I mean, have that dream is enough. So that's what Mr. Yuan said. So talk about that. His dream is not to really have like a super tall, strong happy rice. Actually, his dream is that happy rice could be grown all over the world, delivering the benefits to the people around the world.Actually, he also calculated that the exactly the earnings created from the harvest rice to the farmers. And also he said that this is an endless journey to grow.Or develop hybrid rice. And also talk about that when you stop. And also, like Mr. Yuan said, that I'm not really for the greater good. I'm not really saying that I work ODs for the people around the world. Actually, there's no answer. Just like Mr. Yuan himself, that put more pressure on himself.That he pursued a certain increase in output of super hybrid rice. So we could be more confident in food security. And there's a video clip with Mr. Yuan's interview actually went viral. And let's see whether we have time, then we will replay that interview to our viewers. And that is the year when Mr. Yuan, when he's 90.We arrived at his place on July 8th, and he said to me that I had a big hearing loss, so that maybe I speak louder or stay closer to you. And I said that Mr. You can wear a hearing aid, and he said that the hearing aid is not.Really, like a real sound. So that I just try to speak louder because that we would like to hear his answer about his take on the food security in China. So that's the interview 2 years ago in 2019. What is the most concerned thing for Mr. Yuan?